Concerns tonight. St. Louis's King Day celebrations may be overlooking a big part of the civil rights leader's legacy here.
Yeah, it's a larger-than-life statue of Dr. King in St. Louis that seemed to have been forgotten. Fox 2's Andy Banker is here with the monument that few seem to know is even there. Andy?
Guys, a majestic statue of Dr. King in North St. Louis. All was quiet there today, in spite of marches, days of service, even birthday parties here in his honor.
I have a dream.
We chose to do it as a birthday celebration with a birthday cake.
Along with the birthday cake, the Griot Museum of Black History and Culture featured a wax figure exhibit and posters of protest and victory made by visitors this King Day.
And I've seen the promised land.
Visitors who knew nothing of the giant monument to Dr. King just a few minutes away in St. Louis's Fountain Park.
I didn't know it was there. I really didn't know it was there. But I think it should be known. Well known.
It is massive, as you say. Can't miss it.
This statue is so moving. It's not just an inactive statue. It has movement to it. King's hand is stretched forward, and he seems to be talking to you, in effect.
Journalist Robert Joyner has written about St. Louis's disregard for the statue since its dedication in 1978, a bronze likeness by St. Louis sculptor Rudolph Torini, with the inscription, "His Dream, Our Dream." Costing $43,000 then, part of a neighborhood redevelopment plan. Joyner still hopes King Day event organizers will stop looking past St. Louis's most inspiring monument to the man and the dream.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
When we do the march, why not swing through Fountain Park so that people can see that here is a very appropriate place to stop on this particular holiday.
It just takes somebody who is energetic and was willing and committed to make the effort to make it happen. It would be a shame to have it go to waste.
I have a dream.
Mr. Joyner, who now writes for the St. Louis Beacon Online, has a few ideas on moving the statue to a place where it would never be overlooked again. Where? It would be somewhere you really wouldn't be able to miss it. That's coming up on the Edge of 10. Tom, Mandy.